again. Chapter 27. Whew, last one was kind of sad. Stanley dug his shovel into the ground. His hole was about 3.5 deep in the center. He grunted as he picked up more dirt and flung it off to the side. The sun was almost directly overhead. He glanced at his canteen lying beside his hole. He knew it was half full, but he didn't take a drink just yet. He had to drink sparingly because he didn't know who would be driving the water truck the next time it came. 3 days had passed since the warden had scratched Mr. Sir. Every time Mr. Sir delivered water, he poured Stanley's right onto the ground. Fortunately, Mr. Pendansky delivered the water more often than Mr. Sir. Mr. Pendansky was obviously aware of what Mr. Sir was doing because he always gave Stanley extra. He'd fill Stanley's canteen, let him take a long drink, and top it up again. It helped, too, that Zero was digging some of Stanley's hole for him. Although, as Stanley had expected, the other boys didn't like to see Stanley sitting around while they were working. They said things like, "Who died and made you the king?" Or, "It must be nice to have your own personal slave." When he tried to point out that he was the one who took the blame for the sunflower seeds, the other boy said it was his fault because he was the one who spilled them. "I risked my life for those seeds," Magnet had said, "and all I got was a lousy handful." Stanley had also tried to explain that he needed to save his energy so he could teach Zero how to read, but the other boys just mocked him. "Same old story, ain't it, Armpit?" X-Ray had said. "The white boy sits around while the black boy does all the work. Ain't that right, caveman?" "No," said Stanley, "that's not right." "No, it ain't," said X-Ray, agreeing. "It ain't right at all." Stanley dug out another shovelful of dirt. He knew X-Ray wouldn't have been talking like that if he was the one teaching Zero how to read. Well, then X-Ray would be talking about how important it was that he got his rest, right? So he could be, you know, a better teacher, right? And that was true. He really did need to save his strength so he could be a better teacher, although Zero was a really quick learner. Sometimes, in fact, Stanley hoped the warden was watching them with her secret cameras and microphones, so she could see that Zero was not as stupid as everyone thought. From across the lake, he could see approaching dust. He took a drink from his canteen and waited to see who was driving the truck. The swelling on Mr. Sir's face had gone down, but it was still a little puffy. There had been 3 scratch marks down his cheek. 2 of them had faded, but the middle scratch must have been deep because it was still there. It was a jagged purple line running down from below his eye to below his mouth, like a tattoo of a scar. Stanley waited in line and then handed him his canteen. Mr. Sir held it up to his ear and shook it. He smiled at the swishing sound. Stanley hoped he wasn't going to dump it out. To his surprise, Mr. Sir held the canteen under the stream of water and filled it. "Wait here," he said. Still holding his canteen, Mr. Sir walked past him, then went around to the side of the truck and into the cab, where he couldn't be seen. "What's he doing in there?" asked Zero. "I wish I knew," said Stanley. A short while later, Mr. Sir came out of the truck and handed Stanley his canteen. It was still full. "Thank you, Mr. Sir." Mr. Sir smiled at him. "Well, what are you waiting for?" he said. "Drink up." He popped some sunflower seeds into his mouth, chewed, and spit out the shells. Well, Stanley was afraid to drink it. He didn't know what kind of thing or substance Mr. Sir might have put in it. He brought the canteen back to his hole. For a long time, he left it beside his hole as he continued to dig. Then, when he was so thirsty that he couldn't stand it anymore, he unscrewed the cap, turned the canteen over, and poured it into the dirt. He was afraid that if he waited another second, he might have to take a drink. After Stanley taught Zero the final 6 letters of the alphabet, he taught him to write his name. Capital Z-E-R-O. Zero wrote the letters as Stanley said them. "Zero," he said, looking at the piece of paper. His smile was too big for his face. Stanley watched him write it over and over again. Zero, 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 zero. In a way, it made him sad. He couldn't help but think 100 times 0 was still nothing. "You know that's not my real name," Zero said, as they headed back to the rec room for dinner. "Well, yeah, I figured that," said Stanley, although he'd never really been sure. Everyone always called me Zero, even before I came here. Oh, okay. My real name is Hector. Hector, said Stanley. Yeah, Hector Zeroni.